Be an interesting beginning. Hi, my nation, welcome back to another replay roundup. I'm your digital host of the most, Danny Deceptive Cobras Monahan, and today we're going to be taking a look at a whole bunch of replays that you, my nation, have sent in. As you can see, I have quite a lot of replays that I have to go through, so you got to understand why some of the replay roundup videos aren't coming out as they're published, because I am doing a whole bunch of other things behind the scenes at the same time. So here goes. Now, I have not seen this replay, so I'm going to be checking out this replay, and then I will give my afterthoughts at the same time. It's kind of like a react sort of replay here. I should name this video series Replay Reactions instead of Replay Roundups, but yeah, potato potato. Okay, we're going to speed this up a wee bit, because I hate this bloody load time thing. Alright, here we are. FUD is in the premium. I believe it is. Yes, that's the British premium Spitfire. No, the premium Mustang Mark 1A. Showing off a little bit there. Nothing's being said in chat, because replays now keep track of what is said in chat. So let's see. Okay, he's climbing against some altitude here. According to the replay, he's about 8,000 feet, which is considered low to medium altitude for this plane. Okay, he's got a friendly PE-8 there. Obviously, he's seen some targets down low. This is an arcade battle. So let's see, there's an IL-2 who's about to get destroyed, an LA-5 who's about to get swarmed, and an A6M3, sorry. But I think, IL-2 just got shot down. Let's see, you don't want to be that scraggler. There's an LA-5 over there, another LA-5. This is a heavy Soviet enemy fight. Look at the LA-5s. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 LA-5s right there. Holy cow. So clearly he's looking for a scraggler here. He's looking for a scraggler. Yeah, you know, if I was him, I would probably look at the one, either the LA-5 here, depending on what these two planes do, or the IS-16, depending on what the Beaufort does. An LA-5 is on a friendly P-38's tail, RIP P-38. Okay, no, he's not. He's still climbing. So he's probably trying to get a little bit more energy in the bank. Now, the Yak-9's a perfect target the way he's at right there. Isolated, and the only thing that could possibly turn around to try and help him is the Focke Wulf 190. See, I-16 got shot down by a friendly LA-5. It could be turning around and going for that LA-5. Couple of friendly. Maybe he's bomber escorting it. See, again, me, when I'm in my Mustang, I tend to do this. I tend to go to about 8,000 to 10,000 feet and just pick off stragglers, zoom down, pick them off, zoom back up to 8 to 10, rinse and repeat. Looks like he's found a target. No targets yet. Bowfighter's down. Japanese is down. Now he's nosing. Oh, he's seen a PE-3, a straggler. Toshiba. Nice name. Nothing on his 6. His 6 is clear. Oh, that was. Look at his angle of attack. It's perfect. Doesn't even see him because of the cloud cover. And if he does, it's now too late. 1, 2, 3. Boom. Fucking exploded. Nice shot there, FUD. In fact, that deserves a screenshot right there. There we go. Deserves a screenshot right there. So now, again, he's nosing it up, gaining back that altitude. Now he's nosing her over. Going to bleed off a little bit of speed there. Okay, so he's barreled it rolled again. Now, perfect target of opportunity. Probably the A36. He can needle in between the guys and boom back up again, maybe. Ooh, that was something that whizzed him. It must be just be a replay bug. I'm used to friendlies whizzing me like that. He's going for the Toshiba again in this IL-2. It's like he's got a hatred for Toshibas. I don't blame him. I have a hatred for Toshibas. Really, really, really crappy CDs. And now, this is one of the things I do like about FUD is the fact he's throttled down. 1, 2, 3. Beautiful strafe. Pilot snipe. Throttles back up. Nose is back up. Angle of climb's a little bit too high for my liking. I would have leveled it out a little bit more to more more of a shallow climb. But he's using the cloud cover like a pro. That's his second kill there. So again, he's back in at the clouds. He's using a lot of realistic maneuvers here. Again, that climb's a little bit too hard. He's taxing the engine a bit too much for my liking. Again, the Mustang Mach 1A does suffer from really, 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 really poor overheating issues. Basically, what they did was they put a more powerful engine in this Mustang. The British did anyway, and they also gave it Hispanos, but they forgot to upgrade the cooling. So it's still only got the it's used to being up high where the air's a lot colder. I also put a bigger supercharger on this thing. I believe this engine is supercharged. And of course, we don't have the ability to X-ray. But I believe this plane is supercharged. But don't quote me on that. Lovely looking skin he's got here. I believe it's the stock default with a little bit of customization done to it. Again, he's nosing back up. Gaining that little bit of altitude, a little bit of cloud cover. Making sure the SPAA. Now, there's an A7M right there. Prime for the plucking. Oh, great minds think alike. Right there. Most people go, it's an A7, it's not that dangerous. Wrong. Get an A7 on your tail and then come back to me and say it's not dangerous. Nice angle of attack, nice angle of approach. Doesn't see it. He's coming in for the landing. Coming in for the landing. 2, 1. Ah, beautiful. Even a fire. Typhoon. Can he get it? Can he get it? Oh, he heads up with the Typhoon too. Takes it out. But he does take a little bit of wing damage. The right wing is showing a little bit of fuselage damage. But it looks like the wing's marginally intact. Doesn't look like the plane's drooping, and it doesn't look like he's struggling to keep her in the air. So that's a nice little double strike there. He got another I-16 trying to land. But of course, you know, FUD can't turn around because that Yak-9 and that 185 will just literally have him for breakfast. You forget. The Mustang Mach 1A is a nice little boom and zoomer, very similar to how you would handle a P-51. Literally, it is a P-51 chassis. However, it's got Hispanos, not those damn 50 cals, or as well as I like to call them, the Firestars. Mostly because if a 50 cal hits you, even with stealth ammo, minimum engine fire, minimum gas fire every time. If you just want to keep racking up kill after kill after kill after kill after kill after kill after kill, with fire damage, of course, if you're a pyromaniac, you want to go 50 cals. But if you want to knock a bird out of the sky permanently, i.e. knock their dick in the dirt, go Hispanos, go 20 mils. Plain and simple. 20 mils or go home. So let's see. He's looking at that I-185. It's Toshiba again. I guess that's just me, but... got a couple of... He's climbing nicely. At a decent rate. Yeah, he's gaining... He's not bleeding speed. He's not wepping. And he's about... 11,000 feet, which is a good diving height. Most bombers, when they spawn in, are going to be about 13,000, so it's not that hard for him to weapon catch up to them, or just leave them be. Now, the enemy do have both capture zones. That I-16 is looking like a nice little juicy target, but again, with a Yak-1, meh, who knows. Let's give it a bit of a speed up here. We're at 2x speed now. 4. Oh, he's picked the target. That Yak-1, he finally went for the Yak-1. Again, he's throttled back, saving on his engine, saving on the cooling. Target in sight, hasn't even spotted him. Tunnel vision, 3, 2, 1. Goodbye, Miss Molly. Can you get a double kill? P-fit 47? No, Yak 9K. Oh, critical hit on the Yak 9. I don't know what it was, but it was a critical hit. It was a critical hit. What was it? It doesn't say in the replay. Damn. But it looks like he's still eligible to fly. Or did he die? No, the Yak-9's still in the sky. But notice how he's not sticking around. Notice how he didn't turn around to try and finish off the target. He kept nose up and kept doing what he's told. So many times, people during my live stream, twitch.tv/deceptivecobras, they ask me, how do I use this plane, that plane, this plane? And FUD kept asking me about how the British Mustang Mach 1A flies. Well, now you know. It is a dedicated boom and zoomer, pretty much, for the British. Which was a brand new tactic for the British. The British are mostly synonymously known with their turn fighters, with the exception, of course, of the Typhoon line, which is a bomber escort, because it flies very, very slow. He's looking at his strafe on this IL-2. He's got to be careful, because IL-2 does have... It's the 2M, so it does have the rear gunner. Nice lineup. Goodbye. There's that I-85. Careful. Nice, friendly, shoot him away. Level flight. There we go, 400 miles an hour and climbing. Nice. Lovely jubbly, beautiful tactic. IL-2M didn't even see him until it was too late. You want to know how you can tell if a target has spotted you? Pretty much, if they spotted you, they'll start flying in erratic different dispositions as you're diving in. That way you overshoot. When they're just flying straight, they literally have blinkers on. They might as well be the seagulls from Nemo. My. They're completely fucking clueless and completely friggin' blind. Now, the blue team have pulled back one cap, which is a good thing. I would probably go for the B7. Great minds think alike again. He's going for the B7. Why? Because it has bombs and it has 20 mils. It has those horrible Japanese 20 mils that will end someone's day pretty quick. Now notice how he's going to get ready to do this dive. Tap. Oh, throttled down. He missed on that strafe. Put her in a level flight. No, he's going to put her nose down to gain a little bit of speed. Oh, well, there's a R2. I would do that. Oh, he's trying a long range snipe. Turning in. Tap. Oh, he got a critical hit on it. P-47 coming in hard. IL-2 coming in hard. Looks like that P-47 wants a little bit of revenge here for his teammates. But it's too late. P-47 just can't catch him. See, P-47's managing to stay probably weaponed to keep up. I don't think FUD is weaponing here. I don't think he is weaponing. So let's see. Oh, finally down. Okay, P-47's pulled off. He's definitely keeping an eye on that P-47. Nice. FUD's continuing to climb, gain some energy, put the energy in the bank. Smart maneuver. Okay, looks like that P-47 looks like he's about to land. Very, 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 very stupid mistake there. If you don't mind me saying. You're slow enough as it is at low altitude. P-47's gone. GG. Looks like just like that Yar-2 bomber. Again, got to be careful. Yar-2 bombers really do have some really good guns. For a bomber, anyway. At least some better guns for bombers compared to, say, the Heikel 111. He has an SB-2M, very dangerous bomber. Again, it has a very, 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 very active, I believe they're Shoshat machine guns in the nose of the SB-2M. I could be wrong. Yeah, it looks like the R2's right there, but there's a Corsair right behind him. Now, I would be very cautious here, because that Corsair could easily dive down on me to intercept. But you know what? FUD's probably thinking, you know, stiff upper lip and all that old chap, let's take this on. Comes around. Is he gonna do a loop-de-loop? He is. Nice maneuver. Waiting for the R2 to hit the ground. Oh, Yar-2's crashed. Nice. Couple of minor hits. AI gunners. Minor damage. But that Corsair. He's pulling away from that Corsair like he's glued to a stump. Nice. Corsair ain't gonna catch him. Ain't no way that Corsair's gonna catch him. Corsair's probably got more troubles now with a P400 on his tail, and a Wellington. Why is that Wellington down low? I don't know. Okay, we're going to speed up again a little bit. What's target opportunity? That Yar 2 is now back, it looks like. So we're at times 4 speed. Okay, P40, prime target. Ooh, B25. Ooh, decisions. I'd go for the P40. Right now, it's capture zones. Bombers aren't going to really do shit. I would go for the P40 because it's right behind the R2. I'd slip behind the P40, take the P40. Oh no, the B25 is coming down. Oh, could he get a triple kill here? Swoop in behind the B25, take it out, take out the P40, and take out the R2. Oh, it's asking a little bit too much. But you know what? That P40 is lit, which means he's definitely lit. So he's going to hope he doesn't bump into that B25. So he's going to swoop back around. Oh, there's the B25. It done a double dupe. It did a double dupe on him. Basically, it came around, came down and under him, and then tried to use the cloud cover. So he's going to cut in, going to slice, hopefully take off that wing of that B25J. It's got a nasty gun. Nasty gun. Okay, his gunners are going off. 3, 2, 1. Tap. Notice how FUD's tap firing. Oh, there goes. Looks like it's a surface. Oh, the surface control's in the wing. Oh, lovely. Lovely jubbly. Nice. The P40 went down and the R2. No, P40's back in the sky. The R2's down. Nice tactics, FUD. Going to speed up a little bit. Loops back around now. Target of opportunity. He's going for the... Ooh, took a swipe at the P40. I wouldn't have took a swipe at the P40. He's going for that Yak-9. Got the Yak-9. Yak-9 is down. Looks like Lag 3 could intercept either the SB2M or the P40. My option would go for the P40. Again, we still got to capture the runways here now, guys. We have to capture the runways. Looks like the enemy is starting to run out of planes. I would definitely take a swipe at the SB2M. Looks like the P40 is repairing from the damage. Tap. Tap. No, it was on fire. Oh, goodbye. P40. No, couldn't get the P40. Looks like FUD can easily come around. There's a Yak-1, though. Oh, keep her straight. Nose are up. Yak-1. Danger close. Yak-1. Exactly. Shallow climb. It's like the guy's literally in my brain. Shallow climb. Friendlies. Come on now. Looks like the left wing is starting to give FUD a little bit of issues. We've noticed the left wing starting to droop a wee bit. Looks like it's losing a little bit of control surface. Yak-1 is still on his tail. Dear God, Yak-1, you got a hard-on worse than the freaking razor blade-filled glass dildo. Hey, FUD's trying to do a couple of corkscrew maneuvers at that Yak. Yak's lost sight of him. There's the Yak. He's back. And it's over. Oh well, looks like the Yak-1 couldn't get revenge. So FUD walked away with that with 2,742 EXP, 10 air kills, 1 assist. Just mind absolutely blown. And you know what, FUD? Congratulations, my friend. You flew that plane like a boss. So stay tuned, guys, because here comes another replay. Okay, guys, we are back, and we're looking at another replay. This replay was sent in by a clan member of my clan on War Thunder, Cobra Nation Discord, or CNDS for short. And it was sent in by Rule. And so let's check it out. This is the Panzer IV G, beautiful tank. I'm planning on doing a tank review of this vehicle here soon, so stay tuned. That's coming up on the channel here soon. So we're speeding it up a little bit. Let's take it back to normal speed. Looks like they're capping the Alpha. Looks like it's only the one cap here. Okay, so we've got a Dicamax. Clearly, that would be the target to shoot at. 3, 2, 1. Oh, he took a shot. He did nail himself a T-34. Right through the fuel tank. Hit the crew and ignited the ammo. Good shot. Now, it looks like he's taken a hit into the gun itself. But that's fine. KV-1 has to roll back. You know it's bad when a KV-1 has to roll back. It looks like Rule is repairing. Or not. Looks like he's gotten another kill. Don't know how, but it looks like he got himself another kill. Okay, so let's... Okay, now he's starting to move. I don't know what that was about. So, okay, now target opportunity. I would go for the KV-1. KV-1's dead. Notice how he's using the hill... the hill's under slope to help him with his gun elevation. And also to keep the, his very fragile sides protected. T-34, target opportunity. Send it. Send it. Roll. Go for the T-34. Send it. He's already nailed you in your fuel tank, bro. Which means he's got shots on you. I don't know what Rule's thinking here. He's not going to get shots on those guys. Oh. Looks like he got a breach. Ammo racks. Wounded. Killed. Oh, wow. That was a good little hit there. Is he going to get to finish him off? Send it. Okay, he's killed the other turret crew. Okay, target's destroyed. Didn't get an assist, which is kind of weird. Let's see. 105 Sherman's a really dangerous target. Now, this is arcade battles, of course, guys. So, let's see. Come on, Rule. Come on, Rule. Come on, buddy. Ooh, 105 Sherman's up. Snapshot, removing target. Okay, so artillery strikes are coming in. That poor SU-85's kind of bone. Okay, shell's in the breach. Okay, has he got another shot on that target? 105 Sherman. Okay, that was a bounce. Another bounce. So he lets one rip, misses by a country mile. Now he's got to back off to reload. Let's go take a look back at Rule. Come on, Rule. Come on, Rule. No. Let's see what he's planning here. Again, 105 Sherman's not having none of it. They're getting flanked. I would close off that flank as hard as I could. It looks like friendly Hellcat. This is definitely a 4-7 match plus. Okay, don't know what's in the sky. Friendly or enemy. Again, there's a T-34 target close. Good hit. Grape-shotted in. Wounded the driver. Okay, so he's got two crewmen left in that T-34. On the way. Send it. Yeah, hits the tracks. Send it. Nicely done. Hits the fuel tank. Ignites it. Ooh, that's an artillery ranging shot. There's a Dickamax there. Target, danger close. Target Dickamax. Looks like he is trying to shoot the Dickamax. Dickamax misses his return shot. Shell and breach. Send it. Oh! Hits the, looks like a Hellcat. Finally gets the Dickamax. Grape shots. Kills the crew. Good shot. Looks like that Hellcat is, next target. Oh, Hellcat shoots. Oh, breaches in, kills the Hellcat. Nice kill. Oh, shit, that's an IL-2M. Oh! Get shrecked, nerd! Oh, he's so mad. I know I would be. IL-2M just literally explodes like he's made of Lego. Get out of here, punk. Rule ain't got time for that. There's a T-34 right there. Dangerous target. Punch your gun. Marder 3H. He could punch a ticket too. Shoots off. Grape shots in. Hits the breach. Gets the gun commander. Backing up. Using a wreck between him and the Marder 3. Smart move. Backing up. They have the cap. They don't have to be greedy. Panzer 4G right there. Rule to your left. Your left, Rule. Rule, your left. Rule, your left. Your other left. Too late. Looks like Rule's trying to wait for them to try and get brave. Someone's going to have their brave pills. Oh, man. This is an M18 Hellcat's trying to use his speed to be sneaky, but Marder 3 there. Let's see. Targeting the M18. Hits him. Lightly damages the engine. Marder takes a shot.
Ding dong.
Right in the breech block. Bounces off the mantlet. Oh, oh. Okay, Panzer IV F2. Ah, F2 nails him in his turret. Gun still operational, though. Gun is still operational. Send it. Oh, good. Return shot right in the turret. Nails the gunner and commander. Yeah, I'd be running too, bruh. I'd be running too. Okay, backing up now. Hellcat's got to get the hell out of there. He's an open top tank destroyer. So is that Marder 3. Panzer 4 F. Oh, M18. Another M18. Target up. Send it. Oh, beautiful shot. Absolutely beautiful. Right, range it. Send it. Goodbye, Hellcat. She got her ticket punched. Notice how he's keeping an eye on what crew he's disabling. Shoots in the turret. Notice clear that the turret. Only thing left. Driver. Machine gunner. Finish him off. You know, he does it right. An M3. Holy cow. Sends it. Goes wild. Okay, now we've got to be careful because there is another T-34 out there. Or is that an M-24? Oh, right through the M3 Lee. Grapes kills the crew. Lovely shot. I love the Panzer IV. It is such an interesting tank. Look forward to seeing the review on this tank. So there's a Kraskin 6-2 SPAA there. Oh, it's an M24. Oh, he's got one of those annoying 37 mils. Another M3 Lee. Climbing up the hill. Go on. Range it. Send it. Good frigging shot. Goodbye, Ms. Molly. Headshot. Right there. He took out the crew. No one suffered. You know, no one suffered. Ranging off with some machine gun fire. Still didn't do much. Again, they got the cap. G friggin' G. That, my friends, is how you use a Panzer IV G. He did take a couple of hits in return, but check that out. Oh my god. That poor IO2M. Like Hulk playing with Lego. Bam! You know, oh my god. Rule, thank you for the replay, my friend. Dear god, guys, please look forward to seeing my Panzer IV G review coming here to this YouTube channel here soon, and I'll see you guys in the next replay. Hi guys, welcome back to a third part of this week's replay roundup. Today we're going to be taking a look at another replay sent in by another member of the nation, Robin V-Craft. Today he is in his Soviet T-34 1942, and as you can see, he does have the extra tracks unlocked for this thing, which things I think it's great that they've added the extra track things in War Thunder. Reason being is it gives the game a little bit more realism to it. So let's check out this replay, shall we? As you can see, he is cruising along in his T-34 1942. Of course, there is a Panzer III M right there. A T-60 and a Sherman. Oh, Panzer III M looks like he wants to get into the construction business after the war. Now, one of the fascinating things that I find about the T-34 1942 is in Soviet Russia during the war, they had such a interesting take on tank design. Even tank designers, who even if they built a tank, a prototype, and it failed, they would take the tank designer and throw him in a gulag and still make him design tanks. Russia, you're crazy, man. Okay, so we've got a T-34 1941 in front of him, along with a T-60. He's cruising along here nicely at about 22 miles per hour, which is about the average cruising speed of the... bumped it up to 30. Okay, just playing it smart, playing it casual. Now, I have no idea what this T-34 is in front of him is doing. Again, so the cap has been caught. They've captured the zone. Okay, so he's... I would be very more cautious The fact that you haven't engaged any enemy targets yet, yet you know the A-cap has just been capped. Okay, there's some AI tanks up. There's the first target. Panzer IV F2. Ooh, T-34-57. shit. On a stick. Get out the way, Panzer F2. Now be careful, because that 57 will punch your ticket real quick. Okay, is he going to pop out and let's see. What is going to be his first target? Or is he going to be someone's first target? We don't know. Okay, he's moving up in a flanking position. Everyone's trying to jostle for a position right now. Oh, don't do that. Giving away your position like that, man. Okay, we've got some enemy tanks. There's that T-54-57. Oh! Missed opportunity. F2. Pull back. What is that F2 doing? Oh, shit. What the fuck? Robin, what the fuck? Ow! See? Oh, right to the turret ring. Jams the ring, kills the commander, wounds the gunner. Another T-34. Fire. Nice. Grape shot it inside. He's got to deal with the fire. Next round. Pump into the turret. Kills both in the turret. Target's destroyed. T-57. Yeah, another 35. Dear God. Guys, this is not how to drive a T-34-1942. Oh my God. That's a 43. Yep, you're gonna bounce, dude. He's not gonna bounce. Oh, he missed! Again. Oh! Snap, son! Right through the vision port. Okay, he's gonna use his 42. Oh, right, yes! Nicely done. He found the known weakness in the T-34-1942. He's right here. Where the turret ring is, because the turret does stand up by a couple of really almost an inch to 2 inches high. It's a really tall neck. And it is one of the fundamental weaknesses of the T-34. If you can get a shot at the T-34's neck, see, they realized this in the T-34-85. If you notice, the turret redesign from the T-34-1985 is the turret is actually sinked lower, which is kind of a pain in the ass because, and then a lot of tank commanders would complain, and gunners would complain that they couldn't get the down elevation. With the turret being higher in the 42 design, they could get the gun to aim down. But a downside is that's a great big fucking weakness right there. And of course, Robin just completely exploited that right in the throat. Coming around now, another T-34, couple of ranging shots, fires, kills the driver, machine gun, he's going nowhere. Next round, send it. And there he goes. Nice kill. I say, if it's stupid but it works, it isn't stupid. So he's going on now. Robin's really got to keep an eye on those side tanks there. Crush that. Oh, Panzer III L. Third drive wheel. Yes! Good shot. Now there's a Panzer F2. Is that his arse? It's his arse. He's on fire. Oh, he burnt. The gun crew is ready. So he's got an artillery strike. Ooh, shit! 105 Sherman. Danger close. 12 o'clock. Oh, good snapshot right in the engine. You're going nowhere, mate. Where are you going? Nowhere. Oh, headshot right in the ammo rack. Ooh, got to be careful now. AIs are starting to shoot at you. Finish the AI off first if you can. There we go. Oh, the AI's got the extra track. Ooh. Okay. Next shot should finish him. No? Ooh, T-50. Go for the player. No, just hit the vision port. You're over-angled. Yes, nicely done. I have no idea why the enemy team has not killed him yet. Okay. Nice. T-34. Danger close. 12. 1 o'clock. Well, right in the turret. There goes your breach. Oh, right through the freaking driver's viewport again. Good shot. F2. Danger close. He's in cover. You got the point. Notice how Robin's not calling in his RT. Ooh! That shell whizzed from an M10. That shell just whizzed past his turret. Oh! Tank commander's Oh! Premature detonation. He's got to repair his turret. He's got to repair that. Oh! Dude, you've got to fix that freaking breach. But I wouldn't. He's out in the open. Enemy 109 in the sky. Yeah. Fix it, dude. Oh, shit! Panzer 4G! He missed! I would be so mad. I would be beating my gunner, man. All right, now would be a time to repair. Shit, M10. Danger close. 12 o'clock. Are you repairing? Third artillery strike in. Yes, he repaired his he repaired the breach. Okay. Danger. Panzer 4, F2. Panzer 3, KV-1. Oh, he tried to go for the neck breach. Ah, hitting the muzzle brake again. Oh, this is such... Oh, don't pull back out. Okay, KV-1's pulled back in. T-34. Send it. Why didn't you send it? Did you see something else? No, KV-1's back in play. T-34, KV-1, T-34, sent. Just bounced up off the glacis. T-34 still in play. Send it. Ah, crew got knocked out by that KV-1. He did, however, do some serious damage. No, it was the Stug. Ooh, a dirty Stug got him. Ah, punched his ticket. That's what happens when you get a little bit too brave. Okay, so I believe he's in his 1941 now. Yep, he's 1941. As you can see, remember me telling you how the neck's different from between the 41 and the 42? As you can clearly see, the neck is completely different on the 1942 to the 1941. I'll go over this over my T-34 general review. And so look forward to seeing that video too, guys. What's in the sky? Enemy B-25. Alright, be careful. Enemy B-25 in the sky coming right for you, bruh. Bruh. B-25 coming in. Now he spots him, it's too late. Bombs are dropped. Nowhere near him. Harmlessly do nothing. Now, I noticed he's got a really interesting loadout. He's even got some of the shrapnel shells for some of the lightly... see the shrapnel SH-354T. Those shells are now actually banned by NATO, by the way. NATO tank forces are not allowed to take shrapnel-inducing shells anymore. It's only either AP, HE, or dedicated anti-tank shells. We're no longer allowed to take shrapnel shells. So the idea about the shrapnel... Oh, there's that Stug. There's a Stug, get revenge. Fire. Oh, glanced off his, it did penny side armor. The reason being is the Soviets realized it was going to become a battle of numbers, and what they wanted to do was actually use their tanks as like basically huge shotguns. And just fire, like similar to a HE blast, but actually fire them in groups of infantry to try and whittle down the enemy's numbers. And of course, weapons like that are now actually banned. Again, it's a T-34E experimental. Interesting turret design on that tank. Ah! Got his ticket punched again. Robin, you're getting too aggressive, man. You're getting too aggressive and you're paying the price. You started off strong, but Panzer F2 is going to punch your ticket, man, every day. So now he's in his KV-1. Looks like the L-11? Hey! I know my Soviets, the L-11. And so, let's see, he's going to roll forward. Keep an eye on the A-cap. Looks like they're going for the Charlie cap now, too. Looks like it might be a triple win here. So let's see, he's rolling forward, he's gotten 8 kills, 4 assists, and 2 spots. Now let's see, there's an enemy Wellington in the sky. Enemy Wellington, keep an eye, you always want to keep an eye on the sky in arcades, guys. Always want to. Okay, it looks like they're ninjaing the Alpha cap back. I purposely wouldn't be getting that close to a friendlies if you know that there's a bomber in the sky. Because you want to make the bomber waste his shells. Oh, there you go. Bomber's down, bomber's down, bomber's down. Careful, careful. I would have gone right. I would have taken a right here and used those buildings for cover. You're a KV-1. You don't want to be out in the open. Stug, 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 stug. Send it. Right. Oh, Mantlet absorbed it. Mantlet absorbed it. Right in the track. Really didn't do much. Send it. Okay, careful. Enemy F2. Oh, shit. M4. F2. Oh. Nope. Transmission. Don't give the M4 your sight. Oh! How did that F2 miss? Oh. Finish him off. Nope, your gun's dead. GG. Again, Robin, you are getting too aggressive there, my friend. I understand that you're Soviet, but you were getting too aggressive. These replays are just amazing, guys. You're just stepping up your game. Every single replay roundup, guys, and I'm so bloody proud of you guys. You have absolutely no idea how proud I am of you all. Again, guys, if you want to send me a replay, email links are in the video description down below. And of course, don't forget, you can catch me on Twitch every day, 7 days a week, usually from 5 p.m. upwards, but sometimes I do stream a little bit earlier than that. Until then, guys, keep yourselves flying, keep your enemies dying, and this was another hot replay. Your Cobra Commander is out, and I'll see you guys in the next one, my friends. Hi, guys, and welcome back to another replay roundup. Today, it is yet again another replay from a member of the Cobra Nation Death Squad, my own very personal clan on War Thunder, and it is effing Bam. You've guys seen his replays before here on the channel, and today, of course, he is taking the one and only Panzerjäger 1 out. This is the earliest form of tank destroyers, based on the Panzer 1 chassis, I believe, with a 37mm gun. Come on, effing. Get going, buddy. Get going. Okay, apparently not. There we go. Now he's on the move. Okay, enemy M3. Woo! Get wrecked, nerd. He's on the front line here. Looks like this is a low-tier battle. M3. Sent. See ya. Good shot. Okay, now he's moving out of position because there's a T-28 that will punch his ticket. That was a good shot. Took out an M3, I believe it was. An M3 or an M3 Lee. It was an M3 based chassis. Now, there is only one cap here. It's the A cap. Not a big fan of this map, since how they've got the two spawns too close to each other. Churchill Mark III. Oh, he's in a plane now. Okay. He's going for a Japanese D3A1. Nails the D3A1. Let's see what else is he going to go for. Is he going to go for a couple of lightly armored tanks? Does, but derps it into the wall. Chow Chow Mark 3 didn't punch his ticket while it was flying. Interesting. Maybe because he was worried about the Panzer IV Alphs E. Or Cromwell. A Cromwell? Okay, Panzer 38. Trying to get some shots off. Nails is a commander. Or no, it's his gunner. Sorry. Even though the gunner has... There we go. Another Panzerjäger 1. Panzer 38. Got shot. Send it. Send it. Send it, dude. Send it. Dumped his shot. God damn it. Alright, looks like that Panzer 38's in a nice little hold down position. Oh! Breach block got nailed. Oh, there goes his gun, and he's on fire. GG. And that's why you never take a lightly armored weapon like that on the front lines. Live and learn, effin'. Live and learn. Okay, we're gonna speed this up a little bit. Okay, now he's in a Panzer IV. Panzer IV-D by the look of it. He does have an artillery call-in. Look at that German cupola, man. Germans love their tall cupolas. Don't ask why, they just do. Okay, so he's in the Panzer IV now. And of course, a backing up freaking British tank would always fucking spin him. What is that guy doing? I don't even want to know. Alright, so. Looks like Effin's on the move. Nice, nice. Okay, so it looks like they're going to be taking the cap now. Panzer IV-F is halted. Effin! What are you doing, man? Were you high or drunk when you did this replay? Well, apparently he got two kills with an airstrike there. An artillery calling. Okay, it's a Panzer IV-E in front of him. It's an artillery ranging shot. Okay, they're in the cap. Let's speed this up. Here comes in the artillery. Took a arty shell. Knocked his track off. Track's back on. Fuel tank did get ruptured though. Oh! Artillery nailed him. It's his third loss. And that's it, I believe, guys. Nope. Second loss, sorry. Here's his. Now he's in the German Flakpanzer. Oh, he's letting an M3 have it. There we go. I actually remember killing a PT-76 with this tank. Yeah, I've killed a PT-76 with this tank. It's a highlight on the channel, guys. So yeah, he's rolling forward. Come on now. Being sneaky. He's hoping to get side shots on that T-50 is what I'm thinking. That or he... I swear, effing, you must be drunk, man. T-50. Yeah, he's trying to get sneaky shots on that T-50. Nails him in his track, doesn't track him, though. Okay, he's called in a plane. Looks like it's a Yak 7B. Oh, it's a Yak 1B. My bad. I knew it was a B. Junker. Nice curl around. Going. Looks like his plane got taken out by that Jap. No, it's the German A7. He's doing this stupid spiral thing to try and get close, and it never works, morons. It never works. Just fly straight. Occasionally dip up and down, but never in a circle, because you're going to preemptively allow them to get their barrel to go whoop, bang, and you just fly right into their shot. It never works. Stop doing it. I'm going to speed it up a little bit here. 2 minutes left of the replay. Is that T50? Is he going to get to finish that T50 off? Be careful. 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 Don't be a Carl and back off. Come on, T50, grow some balls, will ya? Come on, T50, grow some balls. T50's dead. Okay, it looks like he's now in a dive plane. SPAA right there. I would be a... enemy fighter. Yak 1B. Alright, Yak B off. Ooh, good storming over there. Another good storming. Oh, ram. GG. GG. Okay. That's going to be an interesting beginning. Guys crack me up every time with this antics. Oh shit. Alright guys, that was the last replay in this week's replay roundup. I hope you enjoyed. I had an absolute blast.